हेलो फ्रेंड्स, वेलकम टू क्रिएटिव मेडिसिन। इन दिस लेक्चर वी विल लर्न अबाउट
गस्टाफसन्स मेथड। गस्टाफसन्स मेथड डिटरमाइंस द एज फ्रॉम 25 टू 60 इयर्स। इट इज द नॉर्मल फिजियोलॉजिकल चेंजेस दैट आर अकरिंग इन द टीथ विद एज। So we can use this method for determining the age with teeth. It determines the age with an error of plus or minus 4 to 7 years. There is increase in error as the person crosses 50 years of age. Gustafson's method is only applicable to the death. To the dead. It cannot be determined for living people, because using Gustafson's method you should extract the teeth completely, which cannot be done in living persons. So Gustafson's method is used to determine the age of dead or mutilated remains. In Gustafson's criteria, we have six criteria which can be given by the mnemonic APSRTC. In this, A for attrition, P for periodontosis, S for secondary dentition, R for root resorption, T for transparency of the root, C for cementum deposition. Out of these criteria, transparency of the root is the most accurate and most reliable criteria. The anterior most teeth are most suitable, that is, incisors are most suitable for determining the age with Gustafson's criteria. As we go to the posterior, the accuracy decreases. So molars are not useful for determining the age of the teeth with the help, age of the body with the help of teeth through Gustafson's method. Boyd's method. Boyd's method helps to determine the age of the dead infant. This Boyd's method is done by counting the number of incremental lines on the teeth. One prominent incremental line appears at the time of birth, which is called as neonatal line. By counting the number of incremental line from the neonatal line onwards, we can estimate the age of the dead infant even close to the number of days. These incremental lines are cross striations on the enamel, and these are seen till the enamel is completely developed.
Hello friends, welcome to Creative Medicine. In this lecture, we will learn about